For as long as I can remember, Nike and Adidas have always been the top sportswear brands in America. Nike especially has always been the go-to brand for athletes. Think of like LeBron James, Michael Jordan, or Kobe Bryant. But during the late 80s and early 90s, this wasn't the case. A brand called Reebok had just come out with a new technology that blew everyone's mind. I'm talking about maybe the most nostalgic footwear innovation ever. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. I'm talking about the iconic Reebok Pump. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. If you're new here, my name is Brian, and my brother Nacho and I make videos on sneaker history and all things related to sneaker culture. So if you're into sneakers, and I get the feeling you are because you clicked on this video, then please consider subscribing to this channel because we make videos like this all the time and you won't want to miss an upload. All right guys, with that out of the way, let's get into the video. In the early 1980s, a new trend emerged in North America, aerobics. Americans, and especially American women, were starting to become passionate about staying fit at home with Jane Fonda and Richard Simmons VHS tapes. Meanwhile, Paul Fireman, an outdoors equipment wholesaler, had recently discovered Reebok at a trade show. He saw enormous potential in the company and acquired the exclusive rights to Reebok in North America. With the aerobics market on the rise, Paul Fireman saw an inflection point. What if Reebok created the first ever aerobic shoe? Enter the Reebok Freestyle. Their timing couldn't have been more perfect. Sales for the Reebok Freestyle were unprecedented. Reebok decided to use the newly acquired funds to tap into the lifestyle market, but with a twist. You see, during the mid-80s, Americans were more body conscious than ever. Celebrities for the first time in history not only had, but showed off their chiseled bodies. Casual athletic apparel was at an all-time high, and Reebok wanted its share of the market. All through the decade of the 80s, Reebok released tons of silhouettes that we know now as their Reebok Classic line. But like all trends eventually do, the aerobics and casual athletic hype died out. Sales began to decline, and Reebok found themselves failing to their competitors. They needed to innovate fast. They needed something that would rival Nike's Air technology, which was rapidly growing in popularity not only in sportswear, but in fashion too.
Great defense starts with your feet, and I have MVP feet. That's why I plan to pump from Reebok. When I'm pumped up, I get support, protection, and a custom fit that's unbeatable. I'm a hot dog, but when it comes to protection, this is no bull. Pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world, the Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out.
This is Paul Litchfield. In 1989, Paul Litchfield, along with Reebok's Advanced Concepts team, developed what we know today as pump technology. The Reebok Pump debuted in two colorways. Both featured the iconic orange basketball on the tongue, which operated the pump system. Both came in high quality leather, and one came in white and blue, and the other black and gray. The idea to place inflatable air bladders in performance shoes was inspired by air splints. Air splints are used to immobilize arm and leg fractures by using even air pressure around the limb to create stability. Litchfield took this concept and applied it to footwear. It was genius. The idea was that the air bladder would provide a custom fit for every customer, since not one foot is the same. Not only was it groundbreaking in design, sales went through the roof and it turned the industry on its head. The original prototype for the pump was called the Pro Pump, which had a dial to adjust the amount of air pressure you wanted in the airbag. The actual pump mechanism was in the heel of the shoe, so as you walk, the shoe would pump up. Man, how futuristic is that? As you walk, the shoe would pump up. The Reebok Pump retailed at $170 when it first came out, which is an insane price. Almost double the cost of any Jordan shoe in 1989. Reebok was worried about this because at the time, Nike and Reebok were at war, and the Pump actually released the same year as Nike's own pump-infused shoe, the Nike Air Pressure. Can you guess who won that battle? I'd never even heard of the Nike Air Pressure until doing research for this video. Reebok's marketing for the Pump was aggressive, with their Pump Up and Air Out campaign, taking a direct jab at Nike. And their marketing efforts paid off too. By 1990, Reebok sales brought in a whopping $500 million in revenue. On the endorsement side of things, Reebok strategically outfitted Michael Jordan's rival Dominique Wilkins in pumps, but it would be the 1991 dunk contest legend that would catapult the Reebok Pump to icon status. Reebok athlete D. Brown from the Boston Celtics took it to a whole nother level when in front of millions, he pumped up his shoe before every dunk in the contest that year. He won with an iconic no-look one-handed dunk. It became the poster for the Reebok pumps. Sales were astronomical, and it wasn't long before they surpassed $1 billion in revenue. Check out this clip of Sinbad promoting the Reebok Blacktop in 1991.
My Blacktop shoes built for the outdoor game. Let me tell you about the outdoor game. There ain't no rules. These white lines you see on the ground symbolize nothing. They mean nothing. It means if you park your car for a party, put them in the lines. How you know we out of bounds when you're outdoors? Let me tell you. If you run into them people on the bench, you went too far. When you run into that pole, you took a charge you should not have taken. You were stupid. That's the outdoor game. Reebok, Blacktop shoes. You seen it? Now go play outside. That's why the outdoor game is different than indoor game. Pain, Jack. I'm talking about pain.
By the time Shaquille O'Neal signed with Reebok in 1992, 6 million pairs of the pump had been sold. What lay ahead for Reebok? Well, we all know what happened. Nike reigned supreme, but obviously Reebok kept innovating on the technology, releasing classics like the Instapump Fury and Shaq's signature line, with shoes like the Shaq Gnosis and the Shaq Attack, although the Shaq Gnosis didn't feature pump till much later. The Instapump and Reebok Shaq series are gonna get their own videos respectively, so be on the lookout for that. It may seem like the legacy of the pump only lives on through nostalgia, but the pump actually never left. In 2015, Reebok released their modern version of the pump, called the Reebok Z-Pump Fusion, which is basically like a sock-style shoe where the air bladder wraps around your foot and you pump it up to create a custom fit. I'm super curious to know how they feel on feet. I've never tried them on, but if you have, please leave a comment below and let me know. Alright guys, I'll leave you with something really cool. Check out this video from the Nice Kicks YouTube channel of DJ Senator. He's the biggest Reebok pump collector in the world. It's super cool. I think you would enjoy it, so go ahead and click on that and check that out. Also, if you haven't checked out our Facebook group, we just started one. It's called Sneaker Enthusiast. There's a link in the description box, and I'll see you guys over in that group. I'd love to get to know you guys better. Me and Nacho are both moderating the group, so yeah, check it out. All right, guys, peace. See you guys next time, maybe in a couple of weeks. Be safe.